Well, hello everyone, good morning, and thanks for coming. So I'll start with my talk with a simple question. What makes an electric vehicle different to a normal, regular vehicle? Well, the answer is simple. First, electric vehicle uses an electric motor to drive itself, and it relies on a rechargeable battery pack to power itself. Now, they're getting huge popularity around the world for their very low emission and very high fuel efficiency. According to a recent report from Australian Energy Market Commission, that there will be around 7 million electric vehicles by the year 2030, which would be roughly 50% of total vehicles in that time. So, as we can imagine, this is going to be a very good news for the utility industry because it's going to give them a great revenue stream. But in practice, they're more of concerned rather than being happy about that. Let me explain why. Analysis shows that vehicles normally return home for work in the evening. And as you can see in the graph, in the slide, that this is the normal evening peak hour of the grid. Now try to picture around 3 million vehicles trying to draw 4 or 5 kilowatt per hour energy from the grid. This is going to put a lot of pressure in the grid, and it will create overloading scenarios in some part of the grids. Now, the problem with overloading is it will create damage and harmful effect to the utility infrastructure like the transformers. And also, it may create problems with the sensitive customer equipments like our computers and television, etc. So the aim of our research is to actually intelligently schedule electric vehicle charging to some other periods of the day. Like a good time can be at night, because at that time most of the vehicles remain parked at our house. And also most of the energy is available from the grid, spare energy at that time, because the demand is very low at night time. So what we have proposed, intelligent energy scheduling system using the communication capability of future electrical grid, which we call the smart grid. So here there are some results that, you know, it takes very small time to reach 50% of the state of charge for the batteries, a little more time to reach 50% and a longer time to reach full battery charge. So that's all from me. Thank you very much.